Hello there, welcome to this video. Let's see the main important steps to make a beginner dubstep track with FL Studio 12. Improve our videos by leaving comments below. Before starting, keep in mind that this video gives you the necessary knowledge and the very basic steps to start. You may need practice and experience to make a professional dubstep track in the future. First of all, the dubstep genre is not clearly defined. In short, it does not have fixed rules to follow or any basic structure to start from. In this video, we will see some general steps that are usually followed. This dubstep track you hear has been made by Ramon Guevara, an amazing beatmaker belonging to the Nuova Golden Era crew. Visit their channel and subscribe for more amazing dubstep and hip-hop tracks. To download his project, simply check the video description. Let's start with the tempo. This is set between 137 and 145 BPM. But there are also tracks made with 70 or 150 BPM, less often. The next step is to create the different patterns that will compose your dubstep track. Remember that all these patterns do share the same channels. What changes between them are the steps that are on or off. In this way, you can dedicate some patterns to the beats, some others to melodies, and some others to voices. It is better to start from the beats. Usually, you won't have a single pattern for the beats. Every time a channel must change, or other channels must be on or off, you need a new pattern. Then, you will put all these together in the playlist. To learn how to make beats, check out the related video in this show. In dubstep, you have no fixed rules for beat making. Kicks, snares, and hi-hats are often used, and these are defined by your inspiration. Quite used are the drops and the off beats. The drop is the pause put in between of a beat pattern or inside the playlist itself. This can be irregular and totally unexpected to get the attention of the listener. Off beat steps are simply beat steps that do play when the listener doesn't expect them. This creates the so-called syncopated feeling, where the offbeat seems to be played in the wrong place too much early or late according to the rhythm. Make sure to listen to your beats on and on. All the beat patterns must be okay in loop, as you use them in the playlist. If you are in distress at making dubstep beats, check out the links in the video description for some free dubstep beats you can use and learn from. After the beats, you need to create the patterns for the melodies and bass lines. Melody patterns contain notes that can be made by lots of different instruments, a piano, a guitar, or even a violin. You can choose the one you like most. You can also use the samples contained inside the browser window in packs and eventually edit them to make them fit. If you want to know how to edit channels into Deep, check out the related video in this guide. Usually, these melodies, plus any vocals if you have, are the protagonists inside a dubstep track, so define them very well and carefully. If you want to generate melodies from scratch, you can use the device generators called synthesizers or synths. Just add a new channel through the plus icon and choose the synth you like most from the list. Make sure to add it to the pattern saved for the melody. Then edit its notes using the synth and the piano roll. If you don't know how to use the piano roll, check the related video in this guide. Bass lines are imported and created just like melodies, but simply using other kinds of synthesizers. Make sure to make them fit with the other channels. If you need help with samples of melodies and bass lines used in dubstep, check the video description below. Another great important protagonist in dubstep tracks is the wobble bass. The name is taken from wop, that reflects the kind of bass used here. It is a very low frequency sound, often put in loop, that usually varies in time. There are lots of different ways to create a wobble bass. For example, you can use a synth called Massive by Native Instruments, or another synth called Citrus, that is included in the Signature Bundle version of FL Studio only. Whatever is the synthesizer used, the procedure is identical. Take a new pattern to contain just your wobble bass, in order to have it independent when you work on the playlist window. Then add a synth that is able to generate or mix sine waves each other, such as Massive, Harmless or Citrus. Let's take Harmless for example. Then, with the piano roll, choose very low frequency notes. You can choose any of A2, B3, C3 or close, depending on the synth used. Make sure to make this quite long in time at first. Then, add to the respective channel in the mixer any frequency filter, for example the plugin Fruity Love filter, to remove all higher frequency components and so to realize a bass. Try to avoid using the master channel, since this will affect your whole pattern and not your wobble bass only. Inside Love filter, keep the path section disabled. Right on top, you have the filter. Set it as LP3, low pass free, dragging on it. This kind of low pass filter is usually one of the best for the wobble bass. Then simply decrease the cut knob to remove the higher frequency components of your sound. This should sound more like a bass at this point. In case not, correct the bass using the synth. However, the wobble bass usually varies in time, following a low frequency oscillation or LFO, in order to make it move. In the cut section below, go to LFO, enable it below and use the SPD speed knob at the bottom to change the oscillation frequency. You can use the other knobs to find the kind of oscillation, just observe the graph. Just at this point, you have to come back to your synth or the plugin filter to find the bass. You may need to edit the properties of the low pass filter, changing its cut frequency again, or you may need to come back to the piano roll to lower the notes used. With more practice, you will get all in a short time. Let's see how to create the wobble bass with citrus and massive as well. The wobble basses seen are still quite static. The LFO added in dubstep has a variable oscillation speed. To do this, right click on the SPD knob and go to Edit Events. Then just click and drag to define how the oscillation speed must change in time. The higher you draw, the higher the speed will be on that point. Otherwise, simply go to Tools and then to LFO for particular shapes. Stop and play again if you don't hear the LFO effect. When beats, melodies, and wobble bass are okay, you can finally put all together to build your track in the playlist window. Don't forget to put drops in your dubstep track. You can do this simply by putting strong pauses in the middle. For example, stopping the bass line, the vocals, and the melodies for some seconds, and then starting again. This pause can be totally silent, or can have a solo instrument in the background. When the general idea of your project is realized, you can add plugins to improve its quality in output or other kinds of effects. Make sure to use fruity limiter, fruity compressor, and any filter and limiter to make all better. Check out our video to learn how to improve the sound quality of your project. About sound effects, reverb and echo are often used in dubstep, especially on snares and hi-hats in beats. In video description, you can download the project template used in this video, made by Ramon Guevara inside the Nuova Golden Era crew. Thanks for watching! Check out our guide for more inside FL Studio 12.